It starts off in Equestria. It's just a regular day. There's parties and cupcakes and songs and frolicking going on. And my character, Tempest, comes back and starts to wreak havoc. Tempest, who is really, like, powerful looking. She's almost in a suit of armor, and she's quite sinister and dark, with this broken horn, you know, and there was something quite impactive about that image of her. And so it was not what I was expecting. I was expecting a pastel flower power kind of pony and with long pink hair. And so I was excited that I got to play the other side of what it is to be a pony. Yeah, I think it's a very relatable character. I think that this film, and certainly with this character, doesn't shy away from the hardships of life. And I think you've got to embrace the fact that children are some of the most perceptive little beings out there, and they're so intuitive. And it's not all about cupcakes and pink and frilly and happy and magic. It's actually that there are things in life that we have to overcome. And that's really the when you discover the true measure of yourself. I was thrilled to join My Little Pony, the movie, mainly because I think any preconception I had of the idea of My Little Pony was sort of obliterated by this new reinvention, where it's really about female empowerment and about that there are many different ways to be a girl. And you've got these incredibly emboldened characters in the main six. It is this huge, fantastical journey that you go on with the ponies where you see them outside of their comfort zone and outside of the lovely world of Equestria. And I think that that idea of going beyond the borders was really exciting to me. The tone of the film is really fun because it's varied. And it's pretty seamless how they all interweave with each other, but you've got a lot of humor, actually. Your main evil Storm King is sort of petulant and really funny and foot-stamping. And then you've got my character, Tempest, who's a lot darker and more frightening and sinister. And then you've got these lighter, frolicking moments with the ponies. And I think that we're trying to bring a lot of humor to the film and for it not to be too simplistic, you know. I think that there's deeper meanings going on. And so it's just that delicate balance of finding those themes and also trying to make something really, really entertaining for people. I think it's a great time to take this series and turn it into a feature film because I think you can make something more fantastical and more of a spectacle. And I think audiences are going to really relish seeing the ponies in this new light. And there's so much room to be explored with the themes of friendship. And I think that a film can really capture that on a sort of magnitude that you probably can't get with an episodic TV series. I think they can expect to see something that's cute and funny and adorable and all of the things that you want to be encapsulated by the idea of My Little Pony. But it's also an epic adventure and it's a real spectacle and this is a hero's journey. Daniel wrote not only an amazing song for me to sing in such a powerhouse moment for Tempest in the movie, but he was so constructive in how he went about recording it and not wanting to blow my voice out because it's a big number, it's like a big song, and I was a bit intimidated to sing it. So he put me at ease, and we just did it in sections, and I just think the song is really soaring and spectacular, and you discover the reason why she became the way she is. And I think that I've always felt with songs in movies that if you're not able to say it, then sing it, you know what I mean? And I think that that's really the true way to make a song really land and really work, is that it's just an extension of the character. And so he wrote a very characterful song that was less about needing it to sound pretty and perfect, but more about really trying to cement who this character is.
Hi guys, Vali here. Now, I love a good animated movie, as I'm sure you do. But have you ever noticed that a lot of cartoon characters have four-fingered hands instead of five? The reason is simple. Hands with four fingers are easier to draw and animate. Cartoon characters are always simplified versions of whatever their real-life equivalent is. A four-fingered hand saves a lot of time in animating, and it really does not make any difference to us while watching. It all started with the very first Mickey Mouse cartoon. Okay, so if you want to watch more videos like this, hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you receive the videos the moment they are online. See you next time.